In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who chose the mother of your Son to be our mother also, grant us that, persevering in penance and prayer for the salvation of the world, we may further more effectively each day the reign of Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul traveled through the interior of the country and down to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They answered him, "We have never even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." He said, "How were you baptized?" They replied, "With the baptism of John." Paul then said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 men. He entered the synagogue, and for 3 months debated boldly with persuasive arguments about the kingdom of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven, as wax melts before the fire.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
But the just rejoice and exult before God. They are glad and rejoice. Sing to God, chant praise to his name, whose name is the Lord.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
The father of orphans are the defender of widows. Is God in his holy dwelling? God gives a home to the forsaken. He leads forth prisoners to prosperity.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Please stand.
If then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples said to Jesus, "Now you are talking plainly and not in any figure of speech. Now we realize that you know everything, and that you do not need to have anyone question you. Because of this, we believe that you came from God." Jesus answered them, "Do you believe now? Behold, the hour is coming and has arrived, when each of you will be scattered to his own home, and you will leave me alone. But I am not alone, because the Father is with me. I have told you this, so that you might have peace in me. In the world you will have trouble, but take courage, I have conquered the world." My sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon po sa inyong lahat. First of all, let us thank the Lord for gathering us as we celebrate today the memorial of Our Lady of Fatima. And to share with you, nung ako po ay bata, ito ang unang-unang Marian activity na nasalihan ko at natutunan kong Marian hymn. Yung kinanta ho natin kanina sa pasimula ng Misa. And we go to different houses every first Saturday of the month, yung Black Rosary. And of course, some of us, if not all, are aware of the messages of Our Lady of the Rosary at Fatima doon sa tatlong bata, na ang pinakabuod ay kapayapaan, no? Hindi lamang po sa nangyaring gulo sa mundo, kundi kapayapaan din naman po sa ating mga kanya-kanyang komunidad, sa ating pamilya, at sa atin din pong sarili. And of course, to continue to pray for the conversion of sinners, especially the poor souls in purgatory, and to pray and protect our Holy Father. In this celebration and our readings today, particularly the Gospel, I'm trying to somehow put into context the message of our Lord today in this celebration, in our readings, particularly the Gospel. And if you will notice in our Gospel for today, it shows that the disciples seemingly loyal and devoted to Jesus. But when our Lord heard them and understands very well that when the time of testing comes, His disciples' true colors will surface. They will desert Him. In other words, they really have the lack of the strength in terms of showing their faith to Him. Maaaring pag dumating ang panahon na yon, magkukulang ang kanilang pananampalataya sa Kanya. I believe that this reality behind the story that we hear today is not remote to the time when Our Lady of the Rosary at Fatima appeared to the three children. And of course, in our contemporary experience today. I know a quite number of people who profess the Christian faith with much enthusiasm. But after they were struck with difficulties and miseries, they easily weakened and lost confidence in the Lord. To them, the experiences of pain, suffering, loss, frustration, similar difficulties indicate His absence. Most probably, my dear brothers and sisters, many of us feel the same from time to time. But it is precisely in these moments when we must understand better what faith entails. It demands that we must trust and hold on to the Lord firmly, even when hardships are pulling us down. It calls us to be firm and steadfast, believing that the Lord stays with us no matter what. It is good that we address this lack of faith, troubles, and difficulties that we experience as we celebrate today the memorial of Our Lady of Fatima. Because the prayer that the angel of peace taught the three children of Fatima, "My God, I believe, I adore, I hope, and love you." That we continue to profess that despite some insurmountable problems that come along our way. My dear brothers and sisters, occasions of trials will always come to test us and challenge the stability of our confidence in the Lord. It is our prayer through the intercession of Our Lady of Fatima that we all grow in faith, remain trusting, and become more convinced that the Lord is always there for us, together with our only one mother, Our Lady of Fatima.
Please stand.
God, our loving Father,
Creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures, so that your people can engage in productive undertakings, and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation, and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people, whom she loves. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, Holy Father, this offering of our humility, which we bring you with joy, as we commemorate the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant, we pray, that it may be for us who are joined to the sacrifice of Christ, our consolation on earth and our eternal salvation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast day of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels praise your majesty. Dominions, adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep into the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Friends, this is Jesus, our Savior, the Son of Mary, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to receive him.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Christ, bring us to everlasting life. The body of Christ.
Amen. Stand.
Let us pray. Renewed by this Paschal sacrament, we pray, O Lord, that we who honor the memory of the Mother of your Son may show forth in our mortal flesh the life of Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.